Hi guys, tabletnews.com, and I'm here with the Samsung Galaxy Tab 3 Lite. This one is the 7-inch tablet. It's a light version. It has been launched in January and actually announced in January and launched in February, so it's as fresh as they get. It's an ultra cheap big brand tablet that we received here. This one is a 7-inch model. As you can see, it has the specs written on. It's probably one of the cheapest big brand tablets that you can find right now. So let's proceed to the unboxing and let's remove all those plastic layers. Sorry for the noise. Plastic layers all over. Okay, we're done. This is what the tablet looks like. As you can see, we got big bezels, and I'm calling it cheap because it actually is. It goes for $159.99, so $160, and it measures 9.7 millimeters in thickness. It weighs 310 grams. It has this back that imitates leather in texture, at least. Now let's see what's inside the box. You can see the usual wooden pattern that was also applied to the Galaxy S4, Galaxy Note 3 and other recent devices. We got a USB cable in the box, the usual Samsung charger, and this guide right here and a warranty. This is the warranty card. This is a quick start guide, so all you need to know about the device is in this small brown leaflet. Interesting way of placing it in the box. Okay, let's close it and start up the device. This has got to be one of the cheapest big brand tablets. I'm sure that the likes of Acer and Asus have rival models, but I can't really tell if they went down to $160. They probably have. Anyway, we have the Samsung Galaxy Tab 3 Lite right here. It's preparing for its first setup. It has a physical home button as expected. We got the capacity back button and menu button near it. The screen is a 7-inch TFT with a resolution of 1024 over 600 pixels. Let's select the language, something that can be easily understood. We're taking all the required steps. There's a slight resemblance between this model and the Galaxy Note 8.0 as far as the format is concerned. I'm talking about design strictly. Okay, input the name. Later, Dropbox, and we should be finished. Okay, so here we go. We're in the main interface. As you can see, TouchWiz is present here, obviously. And let's see if we can turn up the brightness just a little bit. For now, there doesn't seem to be any lag, which is kind of impressive for this price tag. Here we go. Now we're at full brightness. And things worth mentioning here is that we have a micro SD card slot supporting up to 32 gigabytes of extra storage. The internal storage is 8 gig. We also have 1 gig of RAM available on this device. There is Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 4.0, and at the back you'll find a 2 megapixel camera here near the speaker. The OS is Android 4.2, and the processor inside this device, well, don't expect a Snapdragon, don't expect an Exynos. It's a Marvel PXA986. It's a dual core processor clocked at 1.2 GHz. The GPU is also pretty unknown. It's a Vivante GC1000. We also have an accelerometer. There's a GPS on board, and the battery is a lithium ion unit with a capacity of 3600 mAh. As I said, we got Bluetooth on board as well as Wi-Fi, but no 3G. We got a big screen bezel, as you can see right here. The warranty is 24 months, and the back offers you leather imitation. The tablet is pretty bulky and reasonably heavy. I have to say, it doesn't feel hugely heavy, but it's quite massive as far as thickness goes. I like the leather texture at the back. It makes the device easier to hold than the glossy plastic. You'll be holding it for many hours if you're watching movies or reading books. I can see that we got S Voice pre-installed, Samsung apps to download stuff, Google Maps available here. Obviously, you got the GPS to use it. Flipboard pre-installed, Polaris Office for your productivity needs. Play movies and TV, Samsung Link. And let's see what else. Let's turn on the camera application out of curiosity. A huge amount of options for what seems to be a lower resolution camera, 2 megapixels. GPS tag, single shot, timer, resolution, white balance, metering, exposure, white balance, some effects, So you're covered in all the areas if you really, really want to take a picture with a low-end tablet and with a low-end camera. Okay, this is the Samsung Galaxy Tab 3 Lite. This is the unboxing at tabletnews.com. It's a cheap tablet, it costs $160, it's low-end, it has a 7-inch TFT screen, and I'll be reviewing it in just a couple of days. For now, this was the unboxing. I'm curious to see how long the battery lasts and how good the screen actually is, especially as far as the brightness is concerned. That's it from tabletnews.com. This is the Galaxy Tab 3 Lite. Bye-bye.